Now I request Brother Imran to give his response for 15 minutes.
Alhamdulillah wahda. Wa salatu wa salamu ala man la nabiyya ba'da wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Respected learned Christian scholar of the Bible, Pastor Ranjith Ophir. Respected Master of Conduct, Brother Mansoor. All my respected elders and all my dear brothers and sisters. I once again welcome all of you with Islamic greetings. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. MashaAllah, I didn't know that sir is so eager to become a Muslim. I'm so happy. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, sir. It's so nice to see that. And sir, as I told you, is very elderly intelligent. He said the word Bible is there. Where is it? In the Greek. So you see, he gave the proof. But sir, people with authority who translated your Bible, they never use that word Bible in the translation. Brother Mansoor, when he went to sir, he brought a book authored by sir. He said the ultimate truth concerning the second coming of Jesus. When you open it, the preface, it was so nice to read about sir. He said, two statements opposing each other can never be true at the same time. If there are two statements that oppose each other, they cannot be true at the same time. In one time, either sir will be fat or thin. He cannot be together. Either sir will be black or white. He cannot be together. Either sir will be man or a woman. He cannot be together. Either Allah will be God or it will be the creation. Creator and creation cannot be together. And sir said that the topic would have deviated. It will not deviate. Why will it deviate? You said the Bible should be protected. It's the word of God. Torah, Zabur and Injil is the Bible. I challenge you, sir. I gave evidences. You told us two opposites cannot contradict. If it is the word of God, how can Moses in a living condition write down, I am dead. I was 120 years old when I died. How can he write down? Then, about the fulfilled prophecies in the Bible. Sir, do you know? Isaiah chapter number 7, verse number 14 is one of the verses in the Bible that the Christians are very strong about it. You see, Isaiah chapter number 7, verse number 14, it prophesied about Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him. It said that a virgin will give birth to a child whose name shall be Emmanuel. Read Gospel of Matthew chapter number 1, verse number 23. And behold, the virgin gave birth to a child whose name was Emmanuel. And later that Emmanuel was to be called as Jesus. Throughout the lifetime and from the Bible, this prophecy is unfulfilled. When was Jesus called as Emmanuel? When was Jesus ever referred as Emmanuel? Not for one single time. If one prophecy is unfulfilled, it's enough to believe that the Bible is not the God's word. Then, respected sir, he gave a very good statement. Bible is scientific. Sir, from the very first chapter of the Bible alone, open it, book of Genesis chapter number 1. I can show you 9 scientific errors. Not one, not two, 9. If you think it is scientific, I will give you to practice it. Book of Genesis chapter number 1, verse number 29. It says, all herbs and shrubs are for you to eat as meat. Will you eat poisonous plants? Is it scientific? Allah said in the Quran, in Surah Baqarah, Surah number 2, ayah number 168, all lawful and pure things on earth have been made lawful for you to eat. Not all things. Allah doesn't want even our Christian friends to die. Then he said, when he said love, I took it in the wrong sense. By God, I would have booked a case against you if I would have taken it in the wrong sense. I said respected. Check the dictionary. Respect is a greater category of loving somebody. I love you with honor. You just love me, but I love you with honor. So I said, I respect you. So Alhamdulillah, I didn't take you in the wrong sense, sir. Then, about the Quran, because the time is too less, I don't know whether my master of conduct, if he gives me the permission for the time, sir, discounted, if he would allow me to use it, I would love to share much about Quran and the Bible.
With pleasure.
Thank you very much, sir. Regarding the Bible, sir said that this Bible is the word of God. It cannot have a scientific error in it. Sir, do you know Samuel chapter number 2, verse number 8, book of Proverbs chapter number 9, verse number 6? It says that the earth and the heavens, they had pillars. Is it scientific? Do earth and heavens have pillars? No. Allah said in the Quran, in Surah Luqman, Surah number 31, ayah number 10, don't you look at the creation of the heavens and the earth, for we created them without any support. If you read the first book of Genesis, chapter number 1, verse number 16:16, it says, God created two great lights, the sun and the moon, and both giving their own light. Do sun and moon give their own lights? They don't. The Hebrew word used there is, if translated into English, it means an object giving its own light. The Quran says in Surah Yunus, Surah number 10, ayah number 5, Surah Furqan, Surah number 25, ayah number 61. Allah refers to the light of the sun as Siraj. Siraj means an object that gives its own light. And to the light of the moon, Allah refers it as Munir, meaning a reflected light, an object with a reflected light. And still, sir, does not want to believe in a book which is more scientific. Regarding the glorious Quran being the word of God, all this time I have been discussing about the Bible, Bible, Bible. Not to abuse the Christians. Wallah, not to abuse the Christians. Being a Muslim, I can't do that. I did it only to invite my Christian friends to ponder on what is being read to you, what is being said to you. This Bible, since the day one, when the Quran was revealed to us, the Quran is the only scripture of any kind on the face of the earth that is revered religiously, that can be memorized by a small child of 6 years to an elderly person 60 plus. No other book except the Quran. This is the miracle of the Quran. Sir said about the incest cases. I forgot that point. One very good point he said. He said, you see, these cases of incest, God is so honest that he referred these cases of incest about the prophets in order to show to the people, don't do it. That don't do it is Sir's version. From the Bible, he quoted from 2 Corinthians.
God records the sin of even his saints also. That I didn't show any evidence. That was because the time was running out. In 2 Corinthians 5th chapter, 10th verse, it says,
you see, people don't know about it. 2 Corinthians is not in the Old Testament. It is a book written much after Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him. The crime was committed much before Musa alayhi salam. And the correction comes much after Isa alayhi salam. And then sir said that those sins that have been committed were before the law. Law was not given to Moses. The Hebrew word is Torah, Arabic Torah, meaning the law, Sharia. Allah said in Surah Maida, Surah number 5, ayah number 48 and 49, to every community we gave a particular Sharia, a law to follow accordingly. To us, the glorious Quran, in accordance with the seerah of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Sahaba Akram, is the Sharia for us. This is our Sharia. To every community, Allah gave a Sharia. Sir said, those cases were committed when the law was not there. I would like to ask you, sir, according to your own statement, two statements cannot contradict and be true at the same time. If the law is revealed later and sins committed before, are not to be taken into accountability, why do you take the original sin of Adam and Eve into accountability? They committed the sin before they came on earth. And then I gave a challenge to sir. He said, Quran says believe in the Bible. He didn't show it to me. He didn't show it to me yet. I gave another challenge. Read Ezekiel chapter number 23, verse number 3, 8, 20 and 21. He didn't read it. And all about 1 hour that he used, he gave only his own explanations, not supported by the Bible. I believe in a Quran. I believe in a Quran where I am too weak. It's the Quran that gives me the strength and evidences that it is Al-Haq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said in Surah Bani Israel, Surah number 17, Ayah number 81, وَقُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقِّ وَزَهَقَ الْبَاطِلِ إِنَّ الْبَاطِلَ كَانَ زَهُقَ. Say to them that the truth has arrived and falsehood has perished, for falsehood is bound to perish. And I can scientifically prove to you that this Quran is the word of God. Scientifically. Time does not permit me. I can give a complete 1.5 hour lecture only about scientific facts in the Quran. Science, in fact, is not as advanced as the Quran, because there are more than 200 ayah in the Quran that deal with medical science. The science does not say anything about them. It cannot disprove them. It cannot prove them. Science is backward to the Quran. Logical, scientific test. I will give it to all of you and present it to Honorable Respected Sir. I can recollect from my memory, he also quoted one more thing. He said that Apocrypha is canonical gospels. I'm sorry, I'm again going back, tracking myself back, but it's important. I have so many Christian friends. Otherwise, they will tell Allah that this fellow knew about Bible more than Pastor Ranjith Ophir, then why didn't tell us? So honestly, I have to speak it out now. He said canonical, apocrypha. These two words, who understood it? How many of you understood it? Apocrypha, canonical. Who knows about it? Do you know, sir, apocrypha does not mean canonical. Apocrypha, if checked into Oxford dictionary, it means of doubtful origin. Yes. Catholics believe in a Bible with 7 books more than what the sir believes in the Bible to be the word of God. And about those 7 books that the Catholics believe, Protestant Christians say they are apocrypha, meaning they are of doubtful origin. They doubt on the word of God that the Christians believe to be the word of God. And he said canonical. What is canonical? Canonical means upon which the great scholars agreed that these are the words of God. What are the canonical gospels in the Bible? Gospel of Matthew, Gospel of Mark, Gospel of Luke, Gospel of John. Actually, it is not Gospel of Matthew, Mark, Luke and John. It is Gospel according to Matthew. Ask sir, why according to? He says there is no evidence that Matthew wrote it. Gospel according to John. Why according to? There is no evidence that John wrote it. Gospel according to Luke. Why Luke? Because there is no evidence that Luke wrote it. And the same with Mark. But for us, Allah gave a test, theory of exhausting alternative test. Suppose I hold this watch in my hand and I say, this is Pastor Ranjith Ophir. Nobody believes it. You laugh. What is he saying? This is a watch, Imran. What are you saying? So now for you to correct me that this is a watch and not Pastor Ranjith Ophir, you will have to know 2 things. You will have to know how Pastor Ranjith Ophir is. And you will also have to know what a watch is. Allah gave theory of exhausting alternative tests of similar kind in the Quran in several places. Allah said that this is a revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty God. If somebody says it is not a revelation of Allah, they will have to say 2 things. If this is not the revelation of Allah, then what is it? They will have to prove it, not just say. And they will also have to say, how should be the revelation of Allah? I do not believe in a revelation of Allah that uses filthy word like B-A-S-T-A-R-D. I will not believe anything which is unscientific to be from God. So now they will have to prove Allah referred in the Quran this challenge in several places. Allah says in Surah Anam, Surah number 6, ayah number 19. In Surah Anam, Surah number 6, ayah number 92. In Surah Yusuf, Surah number 12, ayah number 1, 2 and 3. In Surah Toha, Surah number 20, ayah number 113. In Surah Namal, Surah number 27, ayah number 6. Allah refers. In Surah Sajda, Surah number 32, ayah number 1, 2 and 3. In Surah Jasiya, Surah number 45, ayah number 2. In Surah Rahman, Surah number 55, ayah number 1 and 2. In Surah Waqiyah, Surah number 56, ayah number 78, 79 and 80. Allah says in Surah Insan, Surah number 76, ayah number 23. In all these places, Allah said that this is a revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If anybody says this is not from Allah, he will have to prove it, then from where is it? And he will also have to prove how should the revelation of Allah be. And by God, since 1425 years, this challenge is standing. And nobody could disprove the Quran to be the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And finally, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he said Surah Maida, Surah number 5, ayah number 82 and 83, he quoted that Muslims are very close to the Christians. But you see, the Christians don't take it that way. Anywhere in the world, if the Muslims are suffering, it's in the hands of the Christians. Directly or indirectly. And they boast that they believe in the Prince of Peace, Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him. They boast that they believe in Jesus Christ, the Prince of Peace. Practically, they don't do it. We Muslims, we are labeled as terrorists. But wallah, we are the most peace-loving community on the face of the earth. By God. Why? Why? We believe in the King of Peace, Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah testified that Prophet Muhammad is the King of Peace in Surah Anbiya, Surah number 21, ayah number 107. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. O Prophet, we sent you not, but as a mercy to the whole of humanity. It's 5 minutes or 1 minute?
We have 5 minutes more.
MashaAllah. And I would like to finally, before I give the last presentation, read out. This is the King James Version, printed in 1611 on the authority of King James, the authorized version of the Bible. And then what happened, you see, if you read this revised standard version, Brother Mansoor, can you please pass it over to sir? This Bible, it has a preface. Preface. Preface means the people who published it, they wrote something about it. In the preface, sir, I am quoting verbatim from your Bible, read it. In the preface, paragraph number 6 and paragraph number 7, 5, 6 and 7, it says, this book, that Bible is talking about this Bible now. It says, that Bible says, the King James Version has with good reason been termed as the noblest monument of English prose. Look at the nobility of the King James Version. It speaks the word B-A-S-T-A-R-D, noblest monument of the English prose. The revisers in 1881, when the revisers of this Bible in the year 1881 expressed admiration for it. The revisers of this Bible in the year 1881 expressed admiration for its simplicity, its dignity, its power, its happy turns of expressions, the music of its cadences. I'm reading verbatim, sir, you can check it. The music of its cadences, the felicities of its rhythm, it has entered, as no other book has, into the making of personal character and public institutions of English-speaking peoples. Great praise for this book. But now, the book that I gave to, the Bible that I gave to Pastor Ranjith Ophir, the next paragraph, verse number 7, paragraph number 7, it says,